purchasing a new drone? Well guys, you should always think about three factors. Number one, does it fit my budget? Number two, does it fly well? Can it handle the winds? How's the maneuver? Number three, does it have enough juice? Does it have enough options like 4K, 30p, 100 Mbps or other things? Well, today guys, I will let you know what was my experience so far with Mavic Air, and will Mavic Air 2 be good enough for you to go ahead and replace it, or you should continue with your Mavic Air, or you should go ahead and purchase some used Mavic Airs. Hey guys, welcome to CuratorCast. Let's get this video started. Mavic Air was launched few years back, and its USP was it's a smaller size, which is it could fit in a palm. Yes, my palms are big, but it is a small, guys. But what the good part was, they didn't compromise on the things like it could shoot 4K, it had good enough battery backup, and it flies really well. It could resist wind, and it has good enough speed, which all boils down how good its brushless motors were. Now, it's 2020, many companies are already launching their new drones, and even Mavic Air was old enough to get a new upgrade. So Mavic Air 2 is about to launch, and I will tell you what are my long-term reviews for this Mavic Air. So number thing was that it is very small, it fits in your palm, which means it fits very easily in your backpack. Even let me show you, this is its original back, and it's really small. It can hold three batteries, it can hold its controller. Let me show you the controller, which is also a very small controller, and it can hold even the charger with, you see, just a small backpack. So this is one of the very important factor which Mavic Air held. Second thing, if you are traveling around in check-in, it will raise less of a suspicion because it's a very small device, so people will not bother much. And regardless of these size factors, they did not hesitate in making this a strong drone. And when you use it, you get that sense of confidence. Even while twisting it a little bit from your hand, you feel that it's made in a sturdy way. So good point there. Now the second thing was that it could shoot 4K with 100 Mbps bitrate that was first in DJI's list, because earlier I guess the Mavic Pro could shoot only 60 Mbps, which is good because when you shoot at higher bitrate, you get a lot more information. And it has other features like manual mode, cine-like mode, even you can adjust your shutter speed, your ISO. Few of those things are missing in Mavic Mini. So in terms of shooting, in terms of quality, it shoots really good. It has a little bit of drawback in terms of noise, which I'll come back in a moment. Now the third thing, see guys, a drone is meant to fly apart from shooting good footage, right? This flies very well. It was a win for DJI because they removed a lot of issues like a bit of unstable while takeoff or landing, or if you are trying to use it as a tripod mode kind of thing. Earlier drones were not stable. This, guys, is very stable. When it flies also, it gives you that sense of confidence that it's under your control rather than drone is controlling you. And even if it's in sports mode or in normal mode, the controls, basically what I'm trying to say, are very responsive. In sports mode, it flies very fast. It crosses 60 kmph at least on papers, and if you see with you literally with your eyes, it flies really fast. Apart from that, its maneuvers are the important factors that decide how good a drone is. So when you try to take some complex shots, for example moving up and rotating, or moving forward with revolving about an object, these are some good shots which this perfectly is capable of doing. And with the sensors front facing, back facing, downward facing, it was a bit of secure too, and which constitutes my fourth point. So the fourth point is protection measures inside a drone. If it loses signal, RTH, which is return to home, is activated and it will return to your point of origin. That is why it's very important that you set your home point every time you turn on your drone with the help of your GPS, obviously. So return to home works. I have lost signal when I have outreached its range and it has returned back to almost accurate position, which is a great thing. Second thing, it has sensors, forward, backward, down facing sensors, which give you a sense of confidence that it might avoid some collisions. On the sides though, there are no sensors, which I think if Mavic Air 2 has, which I have heard it has, it will be a great deal. So in terms of security, these are some good things. Now fifth and the final thing is ease of use. There are many inbuilt features like Droney and like rocket shots and a lot of things which give you some great footage without a lot of efforts. So you can either use them or you can use your manual maneuvers and try to create some good shots, but then feel responsible because a lot of those things, the basic shot modes, they disable the sensors. So you have to use it in an open space. In terms of ease of use, the learning curve is not that difficult. You learn very easily. So that is why I will give it a good point in terms of ease of use. This controller has basically just 4 or 5 important buttons which you should be aware of. Joysticks, its RTH button, sports mode, because that is where people do wrong. They usually start their drone in sports mode and the moment they move forward, it basically flies so fast that it becomes out of control. So always remember to basically start it in a normal mode. And then there are some, you know, gimbal control, some camera buttons to shoot or start recording or photo. That's pretty much it. So the learning curve is not difficult at all. Now coming to the disadvantages, and the first one is battery. Battery is good, but it's not great. You get on an average around 12 to 15 minutes of flight time in a good conditions, not even harsh conditions. And remember guys, if you are flying away, you always have to start returning home once you touch about 55 or 60% of your battery, because don't rely on 50-50% concept. That is just plain wrong. So battery is where you can see an improvement, as what I have seen in Mavic Air 2. Second factor is range. And guys, see, it's a great drone, but they went with the decision of using extended Wi-Fi instead of their own OcuSync, which uses radio waves. And I can understand that point. It's a cost-cutting thing. You get a great drone, but there are some disadvantages if they are reducing the cost very low. And so they used their extended Wi-Fi technology, which is good enough for range of sight, which is like you should fly your drone in your eyesight's range. But if you even try to move forward, let's say around 700 meters or even across 600 meters, signals it start to reduce, and ultimately either RTH is activated or it becomes so choppy that you are afraid and you try to return your home back. So in city, 600-700 meters is the limit, which is also great. You should not fly further than that in cities. In maybe remote locations, it is a bit better, but interference is what causes the Wi-Fi signals to weaken. And so that is where something, if the Mavic Air 2 can improve upon, it would be a good purchase. Now the final disadvantage is noise. Even if you're shooting in decent light, you will see that noise creeping in shadowy areas. I have no clue why that happens. Even I have purchased Nisi filters, I've tried adjusting manual exposures, and that is something which I'm always afraid of, because if there is noise in the shadow areas, you basically, when you are doing shadow uplifting, you start to see a lot of smudges, a lot of noise, which makes your footage a bit, you should say, cheap. Except this drone shoots great footage, guys, don't take me wrong, but if you're trying to do more than required changes in your post-production, you might see that noise in the shadow or in the darker regions. It's not deal-breaking thing, but it is something worth noticing. And if they can improve the camera in Mavic Air 2, thumbs up for that, which I am pretty sure they will do. I had almost a good experience, except when I lost control rather than drone losing control. Regarding range, it was not its fault. Obviously, it's the fault of the tech used inside it. But regardless of all the factors, I think if you get this drone at a cheaper rates on or used drones on a Craigslist, it will be a great purchase. You shouldn't hesitate buying that, and you will get great footage out of it. Mavic Air 2 will be released soon, and so the prices will go down, and I still think it will hold up at least one or two more years without any hesitation. So if you want to buy, purchase that. The reason Mavic Air concept is famous is because of its size and portability alongside the great features it offers, and so it will continue to be present in the market even though further upgrades come. So that was all I had. If you have any questions, please ask me in the comment section. And guys, please subscribe. I don't know why you are not subscribing. Please subscribe. Let me know if you need some improvements. I'm ready to do that. See you again. See you soon. Bye. Thank you.